Hello guys, how are you all? I wish you all are very very good, and if you are not, then you will be very very good in the future. So guys, in this series we will learn about the endocrine system of human body. This whole chapter is about the NCERT chapter number 22, chemical coordination and integration. So guys, I am Bharat, and so let's start with the topic. First of all, what is endocrine system? As we all know that hormones are non-nutrient chemicals which act as intercellular messengers and are produced in the trace amounts. This is the definition given by the NCERT in his books. We have two types of gland, endocrine and exocrine. Exocrine glands are also known as duct glands because they have duct. For example, pancreas have duct. On the other side, we have endocrine glands, which is also known as ductless glands. They are ductless, so they release hormone directly into the bloodstream. We have lots of ductless glands or endocrine gland in our body. Some of them are hypothalamus, pituitary, pineal, thyroid, parathyroid, thymus, pancreas, adrenal, ovary in females and testis in males. In this video, we will learn about hypothalamus and its function. Other glands, we will discuss them in next video in this series. So let's talk about hypothalamus. Hypothalamus is situated in the basal part of diencephalon forebrain, and it regulates a wide spectrum of body function. It contains several groups of neurosecretory cells called nuclei, which produces hormones. These hormones regulate the synthesis and secretion of hormones. However, the hormones are produced by the hypothalamus are of two types. One type of them is releasing hormone, which stimulates the secretion of pituitary, and another type is inhibiting hormone, which inhibits the secretion of pituitary hormone. An example of releasing hormone is GnRH, that is gonadotropin releasing hormone. It regulates the synthesis of pituitary hormones and release of gonadotropins. Gonadotropins is actually the gonads hormones, that is the hormones which helps in the reproduction. The inhibiting hormones is somatostatin. It inhibits the release of growth hormone from the pituitary. These hormones originating in the hypothalamic neuron pass through axon and release in the nerve ending. These hormones reach the pituitary gland through portal circulation system and regulate functions in the anterior pituitary. The posterior pituitary is under the direct neural regulation of the hypothalamus. This is all for today's video. In the next video, we will discuss about pituitary glands. Comment if you like the video. Like this video if you like the video, and subscribe this channel.